to give a slightly different kind of talk today. Maybe it has to do with aging and where you're at in your career. But I see communicating the kinds of science that all of you are doing as being really essential in this day and age, especially since we've seen a sort of decrease in the reputation of science around the world. So I wanted to share with you some of the new kinds of training that our agency has been undergoing to make all of our scientists a little better communicators. When I first started with the department, it was a paraffin's outbreak, 1988. I spoke at 12 sugar maple meetings in 1 month. I gave every detail possible about this concept because I thought everyone was really, really on the edge of their seats and they wanted to know everything that I knew about this concept. There's a learning curve. It does help when you're dealing with an issue that is new, there's uncertainty about it, and when it's about to destroy a tree like the sugar maple and influence syrup production, it becomes something that people are interested in. But as we've moved along in the Vermont Monitoring Cooperative and other ventures that we do with science, we're monitoring. And the short-term outcomes from those are not as clear, and so communicating the value of what you're doing becomes more essential. We set up plots to monitor all kinds of wonderful things as part of EMC. Phenology, the songbirds, everyone loves birds, so the story there is a little bit easier. But all of the details of where amphibians are around the state, the distribution of things, all of this takes so much time that your small story about what you're doing is not as important as why you're doing it. We collected all kinds of forest ecosystem information, and that has been accumulating, but initially the story was difficult to tell. We built all sorts of partnerships, and luckily a lot of these people are young and they'll continue